Yeah, it's pretty fast. This is Bambu Lab's P1P, and it's basically one of their prime X1C printers with a lot of the parts just stripped away that you don't really need for running the printer, and then some more. This one clocks in at 784 euros including tax, and while it's an incredibly impressive printer, especially at the price point, it's sort of a weird mix of decisions between keeping high-end features from the X1C, stripping away others that honestly I think wouldn't impact cost much, but then including some upgraded parts that not even the X1C comes with. With great hype come great expectations, so where exactly does the P1P fit in? And is it worth taking the risk on pre-ordering one? Let's find out right after a message from today's sponsor, Dice Design, and their new high-resolution Orthos filament monitor. The Orthos isn't just a filament runout sensor. During a print, it continuously monitors whether your filament is still moving. With a resolution of just 0.009 millimeters, it allows your printer to respond basically instantly to filament breaks, runouts, or jams, and gives you a chance to fix the problem and then continue printing like nothing happened. The Orthos works with any type of filament and all major firmwares, and you can check it out at the link below. So first off, props to Bambu Lab for doing their homework, because their printers quite perfectly slot into a market segment that really needed filling. There are tons of machines at the low end, around 200-300 bucks, then up to like 600 bucks you can get the same cheap machine but with some fancy add-ons or larger sizes, but at their core those are still the same super basic setup. Then, as you go up in price even further, there's a whole lot of nothing except for Prusas or DIY Voron kits, until you get up to the 2,000 to 3,000 bucks range where you'll start finding so-called professional machines that really market to a drastically different audience. Bambu Lab went for that premium consumer market where they'd only need to compete with the old Mark III or the purely DIY machines. But because they're banking on moving a whole lot more volume than the much more expensive professional machines, they can cost down some of the more advanced features and include them too. And that really enables them to stand out. With the X1 series, and now the P1P, the core is that they're taking the print speed experience of a well-tuned Voron, and they're putting it into a machine you can just buy off the shelf and use at those same speeds with zero tuning or fiddling on your side. Now, the actual speeds that Bambu Lab list on their website are, in what seems to be the agreement with all manufacturers who list speed these days, completely ridiculous. They claim 20 meters per second squared in accelerations, that's 2G, and a top speed of 500 millimeters a second, with the hot end being able to push out 32 cubic millimeters per second, as long as it's ABS printed at a chill 280 degrees Celsius. For reference, each of those figures are about 6 times as high as a normal printer will do with normal printing. Some channels will happily tell you that it doesn't matter when manufacturers claim completely unrealistic figures because the machine is still fast. But come on, that's like claiming your car will do 0 to 62 in 2.5 seconds just because, after all, it does feel pretty zippy down low. Realistically, it prints at about half the speeds they're claiming. I mean, it's even limiting ABS flow rate to 22 cubic millimeters a second instead of the claimed 32. But you'll still get a 2 to 3 times real-world print speed increase over a typical Betzlinger, while still getting, you know, really good quality. Top solid surfaces look a bit rougher than, you know, what you might be used to, but as far as ringing or detail loss goes, there really isn't any of that. In fact, details look better and sharper than on any of my other printers. It does an input shape and calibration before every single print, and because it's generating some forces as it zips around, it is pretty noisy when printing. Mine also sounds like bits and bobs of the printer are also rattling around, and that's probably because they are. When it's not printing though, in standby, it also emits a pretty annoying 15 kHz noise, which I can hear, but you might not be able to. For software, they've made some good decisions. The firmware on the printer, supposedly, is completely proprietary, but it makes use of many of the concepts that were developed by the open source community, like pressure advance, input shaping, and all the other stuff that's needed to make a printer go fast. For the slicer, they're using a modified version of Prusa Slicer with plenty of tuned presets for their machines, which is a huge plus. But here, also the settings are tweaked for speed. Basic straight line grid infill is the new default, and many of the sections that used to be printed as little back and forth squiggly lines to grab onto sparse infill better are now just straight lines, and that does matter a lot when you're trying to get up to higher speeds. Of course, as you'd expect these days, there is networking built in, so you can send files straight from your slicer to the printer, which is super convenient, but just like with releasing the source code of their software that they based on previous open source work, here also Bambu Lab had to be poked with a mini shitstorm to take some measures to implement even basic security features for the data they're sending over the network and over the internet. Jabudo. Now, what I was wondering the entire time when looking at the differences between the P1P and the X1 and X1 Carbon that this machine is stripped down from is whether the changes introduced with the P1P are really there to save cost, or whether they're more of a means to make the P1P worse than it actually needs to be to differentiate it from the more expensive X1 series and to protect the market for that. I mean, just look at it. It's like somebody took a ready-built gaming or office PC, tossed out all the panels, ripped out some fans, and just gave you this. And this thing looks incredibly bare bones. It looks unfinished, to be honest. And it does also look pretty flimsy without the, frankly, decorative shell. Of course, the X1 series is completely enclosed, so it is a bit of paneling, but would it have hurt to add at least some shells to the corners? Yes, you can print the panels yourself, but then we're starting to slide into the "an Ender 3 is the best printer, you just need these 23 simple mods" territory. On the X1 series, there is basically a touchscreen Android phone stuck to the front of the printer, which to my understanding handles not just the user interface, but also the networking, camera, and print failure detection. So this one has none of that, because they replaced it with a low resolution, poor viewing angle, monochromatic screen, and the button set from an Init A8. This just feels like such an unnecessary downgrade. Sure, I get that including an Android device is going to add cost, but couldn't they have used something like the screen from an Ender 3 V2 instead of going all the way to the bargain bin? And, you know, the Ender 3 V2 is a printer a third of the price of the P1P. They're also not including a hard nozzle in the P1P, even though, you know, on their store it costs the same as the included stainless steel one. They do include a spare nozzle, but this, again, is a stainless steel one instead of the hardened one, which apparently costs the same. But the P1P is also getting some upgrades over the X1 series. It's the first printer from Bambu Lab that uses a coated textured PEI sheet. You can actually use both sides from these. Yet, there is now a lower bed maximum temperature of just 100 degrees Celsius, which seems unnecessary. And for that hot end, apparently it's an upgraded version, at least the thermistor and heater assembly, over the one from the X1, which seems to have a weak point in the connector used, so it's already making the X1 obsolete in some ways. So the question is, what would you like to see tested for the full review? Should I go hard on print speed? You know, see how fast this thing can really go? Should I compare real output quality versus the speed gains? Or should I just do the full upgrade-a-thon that they're suggesting with printing your own panels, adding adapters to accept an AMS, and installing the massive secondary part cooling fan, LED lights, and the camera, which is a downgrade from the X1 series, that you only get included for free if you pre-order? Let me know in the comments below. And if you want to see the full unboxing of this machine, including me trying to speedrun to the first print in just the 15 minutes the Bambu Lab suggests, you can check that out over on the More Layers channel. In either case, thanks for watching, keep on making, and I'll see you in the next one.